Hey Jason.
Hey Geneva. You ready for this?
Let's do it. So now if you're gonna put your glasses on, I've gotta put mine on too.
Yeah, put them on.
Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to the first episode of Drag Pool.
Welcome, welcome.
My name is Geneva, this is Jason.
Hello.
How long have we been friends for?
A couple of years now.
Bestie, we only live a few streets away.
Literally just the next suburb. It's so close, so handy.
So I guess for this first episode, we wanted to kind of chat about what Drag Pool is all about, what guests we're going to have on,
What's
in store. So my question to you, Jason,
yes.
Why did you want to start Drag Pool? Because this is basically your little brainchild.
So basically, I've always been a fan of carpool karaoke.
Mm-hmm.
And I love drag queens. They're a part of gay culture and a big part of Perth gay culture. So I thought, why not combine the two? Like, let's, you know, interview all the Perth queens and see what they have to offer and learn a bit about them.
So I think from personal experience, when I'm driving to gigs and driving back from gigs, I sometimes do drop drag queens off home and to the venues and things like that. It's about talking about creativity and about drag in itself and what inspires us and where we see our futures, and I'm inspired so much by the Queens of Perth, so maybe they can inspire others out there. So what sort of guests do we have in the future?
Well, we're going to have a mix. It's going to be a mix of drag queens, influential people in the gay community,
photographers,
musicians, a whole bunch really.
So we got Feminine the Future,
we've got Scarlett Adams,
Sex Pests, Skyscraper,
Veronica Jean Jones,
yes.
Or BJJ for sure.
Claire Alexander, Angelo De Benedetto, Barbecue Coles,
Alexis Armstrong,
and a smattering of more. What better way to start than by asking each other the Essential Five?
Essential Five! Essential Five!
What is the Essential Five?
Well, I'm glad you asked, Jason. It is the essential five things that have influenced your gay upbringing, that's made you be yourself, or like a fuffle.
I just like boys.
The essential five is essential gay movie every person needs to watch, essential artist, so an artist that's inspired you through music or fashion or automotive transportation, the essential song, essential gay song, the one drag queen everyone needs to Google, and your pocket companion. Number one, essential movie everyone needs to watch.
So my movie would have to be, and it's one that they've recently redone, it's Disney's Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah.
So I literally, as a kid, used to watch it with my girl cousins, and we used to sing the songs, and when we got older, my cousins used to dress me up in dresses and put makeup on me. Yes, young drag queen in the making.
I'm gonna have to pick the movie that we saw together only earlier this year, Moonlight.
Oh, yes, that was a great film.
I've seen a lot of gay films or gay themed films in my time, and they can sometimes get very cliche and generic about the whole coming out story. And the reason why I loved Moonlight so much is because they didn't really focus so much on the sexuality aspect of it. It was just about growing up in a very tough environment. Certain scenes took me back to those times when I was younger and kind of first falling in love with guys and just discovering who I was and those butterfly feelings that you'd feel. I felt it watching some of those scenes when the two main characters are on the beach.
And they first
it's that, and then when he's at the end of the movie confessing his love.
It was
just the whole time I remember going next to you being like, oh my god, and I was almost crying. It was beautiful. You need to see the film, it's a life changer. Number two, gay artist.
My gay artist that I like would actually have to be Years and Years.
Ah, right.
Yeah, Ollie Alexander, his gay self. He has a beautiful voice. I can relate to him. He battled depression and mental illness like a lot of people do. And he didn't let it stop him from becoming what he is now.
He's very outward with his sexuality and very in your face about, which I love gay artists that are like that. Like, you know, he reminds me of a very young George Michael. Very.
What would your artist be?
No brainer, Lee Bowery.
Yeah.
He basically influenced the whole Club Kid movement. He changed the game of drag. He changed the game of performance art and expression. Look at my whole back catalogue of looks that I've done. It all stems from that man. The essential gay song.
It's gotta be It's Raining Men. Come on.
My song would be All Is Full of Love by Bjork. It was an essential song for me and what influenced my performances like from the very get-go, even before I knew what or who Lee Barry was and what Club Kids were. And basically, it was a time where I was doing the commercial sort of drag and top 40 and trying to really please the crowd through my drag. I heard this song and it was at a right time where I was very confused about my place in the drag community and where I wanted it to go and what sort of styles I should take on, if any. And then it's the song that I did when I first came out as Geneva. Basically, I sat in a chair with a white gown on, with the black hair, and I look like the girl from The Ring. And then I start cutting my hair and just looking in the audience. The number one queen everyone needs to Google right now.
I would reckon it has to be Hannah Conda. Like, she's become pretty famous. Like, she left Perth, she's flopped to Sydney.
Basically shown everyone that just because you're from Perth doesn't mean that we're at low standard or we don't know what we're doing or that we can't branch out past Northbridge. Number one pocket companion.
I know it's weird, but I generally keep in my wallet.
Oh God, what is it?
I'm gonna get it out.
Okay.
You never know when you need this. It is.
Oh, good boy.
Like, you never know when you're gonna need. Come on, let's be honest. You might be at the core, or you might be out and about, and you know your grinder messages be coming in. And what would yours be?
Well, it's my bag. I always keep a bag with me. A side man bag with me, or this bag that I carry with me. Like, I love this bag. It is
stunning.
Sparkly gorgeous. Izumiyaki knockoff. I hate chunky pockets. I hate having my phone and my keys and my wallet and my cigarettes and my lighter and loose change. And if I just carry a bag, then carry everything with me. So with the guest interviews that we'll be doing, we got some challenges in store.
Yes, I actually have a challenge for you, Geneva. If you want to have a look in the glove box there is a little envelope with your challenge that we'll be doing this afternoon.
Ooh. All right. Today you are going to perform on the runway. But not the normal club runway. Girl, we are heading to the drag races. perform whilst being launched at 200 kilometers per hour. It will be short-lived, so make it count.
Have you ever been in a drag race?
Question, do you have insurance?
No. If we die, we die, but we go out and
start. Oh, great.
Fabulous. At least you'll die in drag.
Oh, dream. That is the dream.
I've done a bit of racing at the drags myself.
Oh, yeah?
Many different cars over the past. The car we're in now is a very fast V8 Commodore. So it's going to get us up to speed pretty quick.
Jason, could you be any more of a bogan?
Hashtag bogan, hashtag Italian vlog.
How do you drive your car? Like this?
Like this. I am currently driving.
So what does this challenge actually entail me doing?
So basically, now I don't know if you've ever been to the drag, but you line up and when the lights go green, you race the person next to you really fast. Now, the adrenaline rush you get from that is intense. So you're gonna have to try to lip sync to a song and keep it perfect. And trust me, it's gonna be hard because you're probably gonna be quite scared and hanging on for your life, trying to get those lip sync to the team.
I do have a reputation to uphold.
You do, you do. But I think it might be quite challenging.
Well, I'm up for any challenge, girl. Let's do it.
Hey, man. How's it going?
Let's get in the check. So how many times have you done this?
A few.
How many is a few?
About 20.
Oh. 20's not a few, 20's a hobby.
So, Geneva.
What do we get ourselves into?
Are you ready for this?
I'm now in my protective gear, costume change, Jason at the wheel.
Hello.
We're about third next. Fuck. So I've picked my song, RuPaul's Sissy That Walk, which is basically the anthem of Drag Race. And if this pun is gonna be any more intended, then gotta do it that way, right? Wow. Oh my god.
Ready?
Oh my god. Holy shit! Woo! Better beware. No tears or shame. At the same time, bitches better get out the way. I'm a fan queen, mother of a house of no shame. Holy shit! Victory dance. Now sissy that wow. Oh my god. Well guys, thank you so much for joining us for the first episode of Drag Pool.
We hope you enjoyed it. And subscribe for more.
Please like the video if you enjoyed what you saw. Subscribe if you want to see more. Like us on all of our social media pages, links down below.